bounce infinity.
Basically, it's actually a wrong word. The bookings have already come in.
Example of what you can do is about to charge. Okay, this is Bounce Infinity. It's an all-electric scooter made in India, made for India. That's what they say. It has been launched at 69,000 rupees, 68,999 to be very exact. But that is with the battery and the whole thing. But if you take it without the battery, the price comes down to 36,000. And yeah, then you can purchase the motorcycle, the scooter on subscription basis, which basically means that you can swap the battery and you can pay according to your usage. So that basically means you have to ride all the way up to a station where this will be mounted, and you can take a battery out of it, use it, take it out, put it in the scooter and use it. So that way you are renting out the battery or basically using it on subscription basis and running your scooter. So the only the scooter without the battery is 36,000 rupees, and the scooter with the battery is 69,000 rupees. Of course, the scooter has different prices in different cities, and you can see them right here on the screen. So in different metropolitan cities, the scooter has different pricing because of the FAME II initiative. So that will give you subsidy and you can utilize the scooter according to your price or wherever you're based out of. Now that the pricing is out of the way, let's focus on the overall scooter. It looks very basic. It's not basic is actually a wrong word. It looks very neat. There is nothing futuristic, nothing busy. I like the red color. There are 5 different colors on offer, but you know, we can't see it right now. However, it gets alloy wheels, 12 inches. It has disc brake at the front, at the rear as well. The motor is hub mounted. It produces 83 Newton meters of torque, which is nice, and it can do 0 to 40 in around 8 seconds. The scooter gets a dual shock absorber at the back and telescopes in the front, so you know, you can't really go wrong with the telescopes. So now let's focus on the dashboard. How is it to ride? Now, we cannot turn on the scooter because the guys are not allowing us to. But this is a very basic, simple display which can tell you the range and everything else that you get on a basic motorcycle or a scooter, but in a digital format. The switchgear is quite simple, which is nice. It will not be complicated to use. There is a hazard switch, and there are different power modes, drag mode, eco mode. The one complete charge can take you up to 85 kilometers. That's fine for this pricing. And of course, that is claimed number. We don't know how it will perform in the real world testing until we actually get our hands on it. Other than that, basic round mirrors, that's a plus one. The headlamps are all LED, circular unit, and there are very minimum body panels out here. So you can actually see the handlebar is exposed, your brake lines are exposed. Talking about the brakes, like I said, it has disc in the front, disc at the back, and a combined braking system, if I'm not wrong. Yes, it has a combined braking system. And other than that, it has major functionalities like a normal scooter. This is the white color, which I like more after the red. Red is sporty, white is very basic. There's the silver that I just showed you, and the black. I don't really like the black because it doesn't really get out the character or the details of the scooter. That's actually the gray. There was a silver, or that is the silver, I don't know. Can't really tell in these lights. Black, red, white, another one. And then you can also customize it according to your needs or choices. The company offers you modification or basic cosmetic changes. You can take the... Now we are out at another scooter. Now this is an example of what you can do with the scooter and the graphics. You can do it to your liking. Now I don't know if this is a cartoon character. Is this Naruto? I'm not sure. But the point is, you can make it look like anything that you want. But we are actually unsure about one thing, that what will be the color or the registered color on the scooter after you've done modifications or graphics. So we need to get that cleared out, because you might get into RTO troubles because the scooter is not single color, monotonous. There are multiple shades, so that can be a big of a problem. Okay, so one more thing about the scooter is the fact that it gets cruise control. Okay, now that's something very interesting to see on a basic affordable scooter like this. It is very, very an attractive feature. But given this, that this does not go above 65 km per hour, I don't think so you'll be able to use the cruise control as much as you would want to. Now, when we were inside, we got to open the seat and we could see the boot. The quality is not that impressive, but again, the price point is very low. So that could be, that was expected anyway. Other than that, you see the paint finish over here is not really nice. The wires are exposed and everything else. Of course, this seems like a prototype. This can't really be the final one because the production will begin. Production probably has begun. The deliveries will begin early next year. The bookings have already commenced at 499 or 500 rupees. You can book one scooter for yourself and expect to get it by the next month or in the next 2-3 months. That is when you'll actually have to pay the full price of the scooter. So right now you can book it for 500 bucks and the remaining amount, according to which city you live in, that will be calculated at a later stage and you can get the scooter in the next 2-3 months. That is what is claimed. Well, one more thing is that all the scooters that are parked over here do not really have a kickstand. That is actually the point where you can mount a kickstand, if you can see that. But all scooters here are equipped with a double stand. So I think when you mount a kickstand, that will not really be a flush fit. The kickstand will actually be hanging out from that mount. So that really can't be a very convenient thing to have on your scooter. Now that is actually how the charger station or a power bank would work for the scooter. Yeah, you come in, you remove your battery, you put it in, and that's it. Well, that is how easy it is. Take off the battery from the scooter, mount it into the charging station, and yeah, fix it in. Put the charger onto the yeah. And your battery is about to charge. Now this is what you get on subscription basis. Get a test ride of the scooter in your respective metropolitan cities by January end or something, and then you can see if you would want a scooter like that on subscription basis or you want to purchase it outright for the full price. The company will provide you a standard charger which will take around 4-5 hours to charge the full thing up, and that can take you up to 85 kilometers from a complete charge. Other than that, yeah, the scooter is actually very affordable, but it does come with very minimum features. It's not very feature rich like what Ather is, or as a matter of fact, it is not about the feature richness, but it is about the execution, like the touchscreen tablet on the Ather. Other than that, the whole connectivity and the whole network penetration,